That's why I call my thing the marathon, because I'm not gonna lie and portray this ultimate poise like I've been had it figured out. Nah, I just didn't quit. That's the only distinguishing quality from me and probably whoever else going through this or went through this or is gonna go through this, is that I ain't quit. I went through every emotion. I went through every emotion with trying to pursue what I'm doing. You know what I mean? And I think that what's gonna separate whoever's gonna kind of go.
All right. Woo! We are back. Am I clear? Am I clear? That was Nipsey. The marathon continues. Featuring the ladies. All right, all right, all right. It's vlogging with me. What's going on, guys? Oh no, my battery's dying. No! All right. I'll be right back, okay? Okay. Time to change the battery. All right. We are back. And so I've been wanting to make this video to vlog my experience about the marathon, a marathon, 26.2 miles that I'm about to do in March 20th, 2022. I really wanted to share my experience with all you guys because I think this is a big step in a direction that I multiple times have been let down by. Running a marathon has been on my bucket list of things to do, and I just haven't had the mental, not mental ability, but the mental strength to get to a place where I am ready for it. So I'm just going to start from the beginning and want to let you know that if there's anybody out there that is thinking of running a marathon, there is a few things you should think about before you do. For me, it's the why, right? Why do I want to run 26.2 miles? It's insane. For starters, I like to challenge myself in many things. And I feel like once I challenge myself, my confidence grows and I become a stronger person. I feel like it empowers me to do other things, not just in the realm of fitness and working out, but inner strength and mental strength. Number two, well, I love to work out in general. I believe that your lifestyle should be fitness and what you eat. Anything that you put in your body and your lifestyle that you're living is a reflection of how your mind works and your body works. So I am all about fitness and working out. Number three is it gives me something to focus on and be consistent. I feel like a lot of the times we get lost in our careers or in our family life that we forget about doing what's for us. And if I have something to focus on, just like maybe when you were in school or when you were focusing on a goal, on something to achieve, like graduating from college, going back to school, that kind of thing. It gives you something to rely on to continue to push forward. So I like how it does that for me, at least. But I will say that before you think about running a marathon or even setting a goal and following through with it and being consistent with it, you have to be mentally ready for it and have to want it. Back in 2018, I wanted to run, the marathon. I signed up. However, mentally, I wasn't ready for it because I was in school and I was focused and stressed out about rent, cost of living, graduating, and all these other things that kind of distracted me into getting into the right mindset to be present and focused on my runs or eating or just achieving the things that I needed to get done to be successful in getting the race done, if that makes any sense. I think that one thing that hurt me in the long run when I tried to run it the first time was I didn't invest into myself. I didn't invest in shoes. I didn't invest in a trainer. I didn't really study how I should be doing things. So this time around, I'm going to share with you what I've learned, what I'm doing, and how it's going. So this video is going to be short. I just kind of wanted to go over the basics of what a marathon is, why I'm doing it, and a little bit about the history. So why 26.2 miles? Well, I looked it up, and funny enough, there is no explanation for why the world or the Olympics made it 26.2 miles. According to a website, what is it? I'm gonna put it right here. It says here that the distance was extended in measurements in 1908 at an Olympic game in London, and it increased another 385 yards when the starting line was pulled back so it could be seen by the children in the Royal Nursery at the Windsor, and still finish in front of Queen Alexandra at the White City Stadium in West London. So basically, we're all running this because, not all of it, but like I'm saying, the extra distance that they extended was so the children of the Royal Nursery could see the race. Interesting. I kind of didn't like that when I read that. I was like, great, this 26.2 miles didn't come from, like, I guess it's the royal family, but I kind of wanted a cooler explanation. But there really is no explanation. That's the explanation from the Olympic Games in London that started. And I saw a video, which maybe I'll post somewhere else or try and share it with you. But there were these guys that didn't even make it across the finish line. They basically had to rely on the soldiers or the people around to carry them across the finish line. So it's pretty amazing what we can do these days with our bodies. That's kind of what I wanted to go over. I wanted to share with you where I'm at now. So I started last year and I fell really hard on my foot. I was running downhill and I tripped over a slab that was, I think it was like cracked from a tree branch underneath the concrete. So when I ran, my toes curled underneath and I fell, boom, on my face, on my hands. Luckily, I was strong enough to catch myself, but I definitely sprained my toe. And so I was out for a good month for it to heal 100%. But that held me back. And then getting COVID held me back. But I was running about 3 to 4 miles, maybe, if that. So I started out small, and then eventually I started upping my miles this past month. So for the new year, I had COVID in December, and so January came and I was like, all right, let's do this. So, started doing 5 miles and then 6 miles 1 week and then 7, and now I'm at 11. So, that's my highest as of this week. I'm trying to run 2 to 3 days long distance, 10 miles, and then the other days do cross training, which would be 2 days a week, maybe 3, and then doing light runs the other days. So every day I am constantly putting in work to making sure my legs become stronger, my upper body becomes stronger, because if you really think about it, when you're running that long, you can't just rely on your legs. You got to rely on your posture, your arms. Like, you kind of have to loosen up and make everything strong. So basically that is where I'm at right now. I'll go into more detail in other videos of the shoes I'm wearing, the gear I'm wearing, the watch I'm wearing, and the food I'm eating. So I'm still trying to figure out a few things, but at first my mindset was like, I want the best time because I'm a big competitor and I love to compete and like do things at a high level. And so when I heard that the normal pace was like 10 to 11 minutes a mile, I was like, okay, I want to do 9. So right now my pace is at 10, 9:30, 10, but I want to do better. But the goal at the end of the day is to finish the marathon and to continue until I get to the finish line. So those are my thoughts about the marathon and how I came to this decision. So I will keep you posted. Follow me on the Instagram at VTheplug. I don't know how you YouTubers do it on here, but shout out to all the YouTubers that are consistent with their videos, because me, I love IG story and I post a lot on there. It's just so quick and easy. But I feel like in this type of scenario about a marathon, I think it's kind of beneficial that I document here with you YouTubers. And so cool. I will talk to you soon, and you are vlogging with me. I'll see you guys on the next vlog.
Yeah.